This video is going to be about the remainder estimate for the integral test, and what the remainder, remainder estimate says, it says suppose you have a convergent series, and it says remember S sub n is the partial sum of the first n terms, S represents the sum if you add up all infinitely many terms. So basically, it says the difference between your estimate and the true value, we're going to call that R sub n, and it says that remainder, if you sum up the first n terms, the remainder is going to be less than or equal to the integral from 0 to infinity of f of x, where a sub n equals f sub n, f of n, and it says it'll be bounded above by n plus 1 to infinity. All right. So in this problem, I want to look at the question. It says, if you use the first 10 terms of this from 2 to infinity of 1 over n natural log of n squared, how accurate would your estimate be? So first off, really, we should look at the integral from 2 to infinity. 1 over, so we'll turn our function. I like to use x's. You can use n's if you want. I like to just use x's because it makes my natural logarithms not have so many n's in there. Okay, so to integrate this, remember we replace our upper limit of integration with a t, and in this case we'll let t go to infinity. Okay, and now we have to integrate this. So I just kind of integrate the improper integral 1 over x natural logarithm of x quantity squared dx, and I think we can integrate this just by using a good old u substitution. We'll let u equal the natural logarithm of x, so du will be 1 over x dx. Okay, so we're going to replace our natural logarithm of x here, so we're going to call that our u part. So instead of having ln of x squared, we're going to have u squared. But then, what are we left with? We're left with 1 over x dx, which conveniently we have. So we have du equals 1 over x dx. So we can replace the 1 over x dx with simply 1 du. Okay. So really, we're integrating 1 over u squared. Well, 1 over u squared, remember, we can rewrite that as u to the negative second du. And this is now the integral that we're calculating. Okay, so if you integrate u to the negative second, you add 1, so you'll get u to the negative first over negative 1 plus c. So we can rewrite this as negative 1 over u plus c. And again, we know that this is going to be negative 1 over the natural logarithm of x plus c. Okay, so that's what we get when we integrate this thing. So what that tells us is, what that tells us is when we integrate this thing, then we're going to get the limit from t goes to infinity. So if you integrate 1 over x natural log of x quantity squared, we said you get negative ln of x. Remember, for definite integrals, you can drop the limit, this arbitrary constant, and then we'll be calculating this from 2 to t. Okay, so now we need to evaluate this part. So it says we'll have the limit as t goes to infinity from negative 1 over the natural logarithm of t minus negative 1 over the natural logarithm of 2 when we plug that in. And as t goes to infinity, remember the natural logarithm of t goes to infinity. So the denominator of the first part's getting arbitrarily large, the ln of t. So what that tells us is that in fact, well, think about it, 1 over a big number is a number close to 0. So that first limit's going to 0. We have two negatives, that makes a positive 1 over the natural logarithm of 2. Okay, the integral test says if you get a, you'll get a positive finite number, finite being the key part. if the improper integral converges, so does the series. Okay, so we do have a convergent series by the integral test. Alright, so it says now, it says if we use the first 10 terms, how accurate would your estimate be? So remember, so really we're going to only use the right-hand side of that inequality. Remember it said if you use, in this case, 10 terms, it said our integral, our remainder will be less than or equal to the integral from 10 to infinity of the function. Okay, well, what does that mean? Well, my function in this case, again, we're going to use the 1 over x natural log of x quantity squared. Instead of using a 2, well, now I'm going to use a 10. We still have the limit as t goes to infinity. I think maybe I left that off a second ago. So what's going to change? Well, the only thing that's going to change is our lower limit of integration would turn into a 10. Okay, well, that means over here when we plug it in, instead of having negative 1 over the natural logarithm of 10, or excuse me, of x, we'll get the natural logarithm of 10. So what does that mean? It means our last calculation, again, we'll still get this first limit going to 0, but it says that'll be less than, well, the integral will be 1 over the natural logarithm of 10. So it says if we sum up the first 10 terms, our remainder will be correct with error at most. Our error will be at most 1 over the natural logarithm of 10. Okay, so that's the basic idea on at least one use of the this integral test, this estimation. So basically, in the process of showing that it's convergent, you know, really the only thing that's going to change is your lower limit of integration will change if you're just trying to find an upper estimate for your error. And I think equivalently, if you use the other formula, the only other thing that would change would be the lower bound, and I think you could also show that you would get 1 over the natural logarithm of 11 being your lower estimate. Okay, so that's supposed to be 11, natural logarithm of 11. Alright, I hope this video helps. It makes a little bit of sense. Like I said, to be able to use it, you have to make sure your integration techniques are okay, because you know, any of the series that you see, you know, it's anyone, you may have a variety of integration techniques when you have to integrate these. So, anyways, all right, good luck out there. I hope this helps.